This is where I live. Well, not outside the apartment, but inside. I have been staying here for about 6 months. The apartment belongs to these two girls I live with. Their friend Namrata stays here too, but I am with these two girls. The arrangement might sound a little unconventional, but it suits us fine. This is my typical morning.
Sharika.
What?
Get up. Look at the room. It's such a mess. I just cleaned it up last night.
Stop yelling at me in the morning as if I messed it up. He must have messed it up. He always messes the rooms.
I don't know why we let him into our lives, because he just messes up everything around the house.
I clean up after him all the time.
I cook and make sure he eats things he wants.
Well, he pays more attention to me after all your cooking. Guess isn't that great.
What is your problem? At least I know how to cook. You were not even around when he came into my life.
Stop acting like a baby. And let's not pretend that he's faithful to either one of us. And I love him a lot too, okay? Maybe even more.
I heard that. Nee chelappam endu venengam parayan thodangiya. There you are. We were just talking about you. Look at the room. It's such a mess. Every day I have to clean up.
I'm sure you think that I would feel remorseful about all this. But when the same thing happens to you every morning, you learn to ignore it.
Where are you going? Stop walking away when I'm talking to you. Now he goes into the bathroom.
I don't have time for this. I have lots to do. I'll go get breakfast started. You just brush your teeth or something and make sure you come on time now.
Why do you make him breakfast every day? You never let me do anything for him. It's like you're trying to buy his affection.
What buy his affection? Till now, you were complaining about how you hated doing things for him. Suddenly, you won't be a slave.
Oh, and what were you doing, declaring your love for him?
Sharika, whatever. I don't have time for this. I have to get breakfast started.
I'm getting him breakfast, okay? It's not like you own him or anything.
I bet he wants to be with a shrew like you.
Oh, and I bet he wants to be with a crybaby like you.
A crybaby? Sharika,
again? I don't get it. Every morning you guys are at each other's throat. Do you realize that?
Yeah, she's right.
Yes. I know I say this every day, and I'm going to say this again. I think you should really reconsider your whole weird relationship triangle with him. Either you get him to leave, or put your foot down about your lack of love, respect, and we're messing up the house. He comes in and goes out whenever he feels like, and God knows where he goes.
But how can you make him leave, Namrata? I really can't live without him.
I know that's not the answer. That's way too drastic. Personally, I think you guys should make him leave. I never liked him and never will. He's got evil eyes.
Evil eyes?
What are you talking about? He's got beautiful eyes. Okay, I thought love was blind, not crazy.
Every day I should tell you what you should do. Now I'm not getting involved in this anymore. And I think it's not right for both of you. But I like him. Even though he's a little crazy, it's fun to be with.
You must decide for yourselves what you should do. It's not every day I have the same face every day. I'm not saying he's bad or anything.
Bad? He's horrible.
Whatever. What I was saying is I just think. And at the end of it all, it doesn't matter what I think or what she thinks. It's a decision for both of you to make.
Pravesh is right, Sharika. We cannot go on like this. It's not correct.
Yeah. You know what? I think we should make him leave.
Let's do it, actually. Let's make him leave.
No.
He has gone on for so long. Let's just do it.
You got him.
Look at him, he's so wonderful.
I know. It doesn't matter if he doesn't pay us any love or affection, if he messes up the room. The point is that we love him and that's all that counts.
I was never worried. I knew they would never make me leave. This happens every morning. This is my typical morning. What do I do now? I let them take me into their arms and I bite their hands. After all, that's what cats do.
Well, little lady, let me elucidate here. Everybody wants to be a cat. Because a cat's the only cat who knows where it's at.
Tell me, everybody's picking up on that feline beat. Cause everything else is obsolete. A square with a horn makes you wish you weren't born.
Every time he plays.
But with a square in the act, you can set music back.
Through the game and days of troubles in.
I've heard some corny birds who tried to sing.
Still a cat's the only cat who knows how to swing.
Who wants to dick, long head dick, stuff like that?
When everybody wants to be a cat, a square with a horn makes you wish you weren't born. Every time he plays, oh, a rinky tinky dinky with a square in the act, you can set music back to the caveman days.
Oh, a rinky tinky tinky.
Yes, everybody wants to be a cat. Because a cat's the only cat who knows where it's at. When playing jazz, you always has a welcome mat. Everybody digs a swinging cat.